Dear Corsair, the keyboard aristocrats aren't too fond of you. They say your keyboards are overpriced. They complain about having only 256 colors of RGB. They complain about your new logo. They complain about the non-standard bottom row. But as the king of macros, I don't care about any of that. You know what I do care about? The Corsair Utility Engine 2. It's fantastic. On any keyboard that supports Q software, I'm able to reprogram every single key. Rockat keyboards are only partially reprogrammable.
Complex macro sequences.
Tesoro's software doesn't have all the features I need, and it seems to be different with each keyboard. The recent Genovation KB170L only has 66 macro keys, and the software is something straight out of 2001. And Logitech keyboards aren't reprogrammable at all. Only the macro keys are reprogrammable. Even the legendary Logitech G15 only had 18 of them. And I loved this keyboard. So imagine how I must feel about the Corsair K95 RGB. It's got 126 macro keys. As the macro king, this pleases me. And on top of that, you've got, I think, unlimited profiles to change the layout of the entire keyboard with just a single button press. Or better yet, I can link a specific profile to a specific application. It's brilliant! But here's the problem. If I plug in multiple Corsair keyboards, I am not able to assign different profiles to different keyboards. They all act like the same keyboard. This is a problem that Windows has had for its entire lifespan. It can't tell the difference between multiple keyboards. For over 2 years, I've been looking for an airtight method of assigning a second keyboard as a unique input. I found a way to do it using Lua Macros, and my video on the subject was immensely popular. But the solution was slow and limited to only one key at a time, and it didn't always work. It turns out that applications like Lua Macros have some serious problems that are insurmountable. So I kept looking, and I found Oblitum Interception. It's a driver-based solution that works perfectly. But it's a huge pain to set it all up correctly, and even then, it's only limited to 10 device drivers per reboot. So, long story short, if you plug in too many USB devices, they stop working. And to remove this limitation, I would have to pay $2,200. I wish I was joking. So then I thought, okay, surely if I just swapped out all of my keyboards for Corsair keyboards, then Q 2.0 would be able to tell the difference between them. Nope. Can't do it. Corsair, you're so close! So close to being the ultimate macro solution for the everyman. You already have all the expensive drivers. I know you do, because I can see them. They're right here. The K95 uses 4 of these. With those drivers, your Q software can already tell the difference between a Corsair keyboard and a non-Corsair keyboard. So if I use a Logitech G910 as my primary keyboard, I could use the Corsair K95 purely for macro keys. This entire video could have been, just use a Corsair keyboard as your secondary keyboard. But I want to use the K95 as my primary keyboard. Why are you doing this, Corsair? Why are you discouraging us from owning and using more than one of your keyboards at a time? Why would you do that? Look, all we need is the ability to make a profile that is unique to a specific keyboard. Everything else is already in place. You do that, and Corsair suddenly has the ability to do something that no other keyboard manufacturer has accomplished. A lot of working professionals will swear by the usefulness of devices like the Razer Tartarus or the Logitech G13. Really? $100 for 25 keys? $4 a key? These additional input devices have always been significantly more expensive than a normal keyboard. But there's no reason for that. You can dominate this market with an incredibly simple solution. Just buy a Corsair keyboard instead. By the way, I do think you guys should offer a standalone Q-enabled numpad like this. Anyway, take a look at these expensive solutions that people keep sending me. $1.83 per macro, $2.50 per macro, $4 per macro, $4.54, $5.83, $6.25, $7.50, and $25 per macro. But even the most expensive Corsair keyboard, the K95 Platinum, is only $149 per macro. And what's the cheapest Corsair keyboard that still supports Q? The K63. It's even on sale. That's 80 cents per macro key for the ultimate, airtight, easy to customize macro solution for the everyman. Corsair, you're like 99% of the way there. Just take one more step. Add this feature. Make me proud. Sincerely, the Macro King.